All right, what's up, everyone, and welcome to the 2025-2026 Boys Uncommitted All Long Island Games Virtual Draft. I'm your host, Ellis Joshua, this evening, and just a little bit about the style of this draft and how it's going to work is we have two designated captains per team, so two captains for the black team, two captains for the silver team, and they'll be making their selections for their respective teams, both offensively and defensively. So what we'll do is we'll have them each select their starters. We'll bring on the first two captains. They'll select their starting attack, then reserve attack. Then we'll shift over to midfield, and it'll be the same process. Starters followed by reserves. And then we'll have our defensive captains come on, and then they'll be doing the same thing for the defense and the goalies. So what we'll do is we'll start with our offensive captains, so our middies and attack captains. So one of our captains for the 25-26 uncommitted game, he hails from Cold Spring Harbor. He is still alive in the high school season, and that would be Sam Bruno. So Sam, we got you up on the screen. How's it going here this evening?
Going well, yeah. I'm excited to be here. So,
well, it's great to have you, and I'm definitely looking forward to seeing you as well. Continue your high school season as you guys just recently won the Class D Long Island Championship. So congrats to you and your team success.
Thank you.
Absolutely. Now, our other offensive captain, he hails from Smithtown West, and this is one of the top attackers still on the board for college coaches out there, and that would be Liam Byrne. We got Liam Byrne up on the screen. Liam, how's it going here this evening?
It's going pretty good. Happy to be here.
Awesome. Well, it's great to have you guys. Thank you both for taking part in this draft. And so what we'll do to get things started is we're going to start off with the attack. And so we'll do a coin toss to decide who either gets first pick or who will make their selections back-to-back consecutively, picks 2 and 3, to begin with the starting attack. So what we'll do is, Liam, since we brought you on second, we'll have you give the coin toss here. If you want to pick heads or tails, what will it be?
Tails.
All right, so Liam says tails. I'll use my phone here to flip a coin. Hey, Siri, flip a coin.
Tails.
It is tails. So Liam, you get to decide, would you like to pick first or would you like to defer to Sam and then have picks 2 and 3 back to back?
Let's go picks 2 and 3 back to back.
All right. So Liam, you're going to defer. So that means Sam, you get the first pick, starting with attack. So who is going to be your first selection as one of the starting attackmen on your team?
I'm going to go with Roger Testa.
All right, Roger Testa, someone that you, of course, know well as a high school teammate at Cold Spring Harbor, someone that you're very familiar with, also on the club circuit as well. So, Sam, what was kind of the thought process behind picking Roger as your teammate first overall?
I think he's a versatile player. He can put the ball in the back of the net. He's gritty and can get it done.
Nice. So going with someone you know well. I like the familiarity. And I like the chemistry. So that is your first selection for your team. So now, Liam, it goes back to you for consecutive picks at attack. So since you're one of the starting attackmen, of course, you'll make back-to-back picks, and that will be your trio of attackmen for your starting lineup. So we'll have you make one pick. We'll have their graphic up on the screen, do a little description, and then we'll turn back to you for your second pick.
All right. For my first pick, let's go with Chase Ritzy.
All right. So Chase Ritzy out of Harborfields. Now, what was kind of your thinking there, Liam, with making Ritzy as your first pick, as one of your teammates at attack?
I mean, during the season, we played against him, against Harborfields, and I liked his play style and think it could be pretty good.
Nice. Someone that you played against, but just getting a chance to see their game. It's like, you never know when you might be playing with a teammate, like playing with someone like that as a teammate. So I like it. You'll get a chance to suit up with him for the All Long Island games. Okay, so now you get to make your second consecutive pick. So who is going to be next for you as your other starting attackman?
Let's go with Grayson Cabrera.
All right, so Grayson Cabrera out of Northport. So Cabrera going to be playing with you, Liam Byrne, as well. And Cabrera, he definitely had a big time season for the Tigers as they went to the county championship this year. Came up just a bit short, but Cabrera, look out for his name in the 26 class coming up this summer, as he'll likely have a big season of summer ball ahead of him. So now what we'll do is we'll go back to you, Sam. And since we're still doing the starting attack, so you still have two more to choose from since you're a middie. So you'll have two more attackmen to choose from. So you can now go back to back with your selections, and that would round out your three starting attackmen. So who's going to be your next pick at attack?
I think I'm going to go with Nolan Hopper.
Nolan Hopper out of Chaminade. That's a name where definitely watch out for him in the future, playing for Chaminade's varsity team. Getting a chance to cover Nolan. This is going back a couple years ago on the club circuit, but someone that can absolutely fill it up. He's definitely one of the bigger guys in the 26 class. Definitely a truck. He's got some size to him for sure. So definitely going to be interesting as one of the starting attackmen for Team Sammy Bruno here. So Sam, what's going to be your next selection, which will then round out your trio of starting attackmen?
I think I'm going to go with Zach Fishman.
Zach Fishman out of Comac. All right. So we got Fishman now off the board. And Fishman, I remember getting a chance. This is going back to the fall. And this was the regulators game against Shore to Shore. Of course, Sam, your team was part of that game.
Yeah.
And getting a chance to cover Zach Fishman in that game, and as well for his high school team at Comac. So any familiarity with going up against him potentially on the club circuit?
Yeah, I remember when we played him in the fall. I think he had like two goals and an assist or something like that. I remember him playing great. I liked his style of play, and he could put the ball in the net, and that's what we need. So
nice. So all right, so we're now shifting over to the Fogos for the 25-26 uncommitted game. So we'll have Liam Byrne make the first pick. Fogos, pretty short and sweet. So Liam, who are you going to be rolling with as your Fogo?
We're going to go with Paul Lenegro.
All right, so we got Paul Lenegro, the St. Anthony's Friar in the 2026 class. So, Liam, just kind of talk about your thought process in going with Lenegro as your guy that you're going to look to hopefully get a lot of possessions for your team.
I don't really have any personal experience with him, but I remember seeing a few clips, whether it was Instagram or YouTube, of him, and I thought – he looked pretty good, and I think he should be good for us at the X.
Nice. So, you know, sometimes it's just about seeing a kid's highlights on Instagram or on YouTube, and you can easily see, like, okay, like that's a dog right there. That's someone that I would definitely want to play with. So I like it. So now, Sam, if you would mind just reading off our other Fogo here that will be playing on your team.
Yeah, Leo Cataldo.
All right, so we got Leo Cataldo out of Bethpage. So Cataldo playing with Team Bruno, and he's going to be looked upon to get a ton of possessions for your team, Sam. But any kind of thoughts just about Cataldo as a player? Have you played against him at all, and any familiarity there?
Not too familiar, but I heard he's quick off the whistle, clean exits, and he could get us the ball the whole game.
Nice. So we got the Fogos selected here for the 25-26 uncommitted game. So now what we'll do is we'll transition over now to the midfield, and it's going to be similar to how you guys picked attack. So you guys will pick your starting midfield, and then after the starters are selected, then we'll go about picking the reserves. So I think what we can do now is we can do another coin toss here just to decide who would like first pick, or if they would like to defer and go back to back. So this time we'll have Sam make the call. So Sam, are you rolling with heads or tails?
I'm gonna go with tails.
All right. Hey Siri, coin.
I'm here.
Flip a coin. Oh, let's try this one more time. Hey Siri, flip a coin.
It's tails.
It is tails. All right, so Sam, so would you like to select first overall, or would you like to go back-to-back and defer?
I'll defer.
All right, so you're going to defer. So that means, Liam, you get the first pick as your starting midfielder. So who's going to be pick number one for you?
Let's go with Tim McDonald.
Timmy McDonald out of Huntington, the Huntington Blue Devil. So any familiarity there, Liam, with going with McDonald? Is that someone that you may have seen, played against potentially, or someone that you might know at all? Just what were your thoughts there with going with McDonald?
Yeah, in the Long Island Lacrosse Journal Winter League, Smithtown West, we played against Huntington, and I remember playing against him. He's like good both ends of the ball, scrappy, and I think he should fit well with us.
Nice. I like it. Going back to the Winter League and remembering his style of play. I like that. Timmy, definitely someone who's absolutely gritty and gets after it for sure. Definitely is a tough kid for sure. So I like the selection. So now, Sam, you get back-to-back picks here. So you'll be picking your consecutive picks. We'll round out your starting midfield since you are a midfielder as well. So we'll go with your consecutive picks. So you'll pick one. We'll have their graphic pop up, and then we'll talk a little bit about them, and then you'll make your next pick. So who's going to be first for you at midfield?
I'm going to go with Tommy Leader from Manhasset.
Ooh, Tommy Leader, the sophomore. I like the selection. Leader, that's someone who's definitely displayed the clutch gene during the season for Manhasset. He's come up with some big-time goals for, of course, a perennial contender in Manhasset. Actually had a game-tying and game-winning goal earlier this season for Manhasset. So he's definitely one that has the clutch gene in his bones for sure. So we got Leader going to Team Sammy Bruno as his first selection at midfield. So now, Sam, who is going to be your next pick?
I'm going to go with Rex O'Connor.
Rex O'Connor, okay. Someone, of course, that you know, being from the same high school, Cold Spring Harbor. So was that kind of your thinking there in going with Rex, someone that's a teammate of yours at the high school level?
Yeah, definitely. I love playing with Rex. He's good both sides of the ball. He can run up and down. So,
all right. So we got O'Connor and we got Bruno as two CSH midfielders in that starting lineup for the All Long Island games. So Sam, your starting midfield is wrapped up when you include yourself. So now we'll go back to you, Liam, and you'll make back-to-back picks, and that will then round out your starting midfield before we then transition to the reserves. So, Liam, who are you going to be picking next as one of your starting middies?
We're going to go with Luke Loyacano.
Oh, Luke Loyacano. So that's someone. He definitely knows what it's like to play on the big stage and have a big game. Loyacano out of Northport in the 26 class. So college coaches definitely look out for him over the summer. But I remember he delivered a huge game in the county semis last year for Northport against Ward Melville. As a freshman last year, I believe he stepped up with 5 goals, and he was just super impressive. One of the top goal scorers from the midfield in that game specifically for Northport. So he's one that absolutely knows a big game. So I do like the selection. And now, Liam, you get one more pick as well to wrap up your starting midfield before we pick the reserve. So who's going to be your next pick?
Let's go with Kai Jankow.
Kai Jankow out of Babylon. Jankow, he was on a team that had great success this season. The Babylon Panthers made it to the Long Island Championship game. So, Sam, you actually just got a chance to play against him and his team just yesterday. So you got a chance to see him out there. But Jankow, another one of those players for Babylon that was very instrumental as a sophomore in their success this season in winning a county championship and going to the Long Island Championship game. So we got Kai Jankow to round out the starting midfield. So guys, just want to thank you for taking part in this draft and accepting the honor of being a captain. And we're really looking forward to seeing you guys compete in the games on June 19th. So what we're going to do is we're going to have you guys go back into the waiting room. We'll bring on our other two captains and have them pick the defensive players, and then we'll bring you back on in a little bit to wrap up.
All right, perfect. Thank you.
All right, thank you.
All right, so now we're going to transition to our defensive side of the ball, and we're going to bring on our two defensive captains. So what we're going to do is we're going to introduce our first captain, who is a defenseman, and he hails from St. Anthony's in the 25 class, and that would be Justice Durham. So we got Justice Durham as one of our defensive captains. We got Justice on the screen. Justice, how's it going here this evening?
I'm doing great. I'm just happy to be here. Thank you.
Absolutely. So Durham, of course, you were part of a St. Anthony's team that once again won another Catholic League championship. So congrats on the success of the St. Anthony's Friars this year, bringing home another chip. And looking forward to seeing you compete in the All Long Island Games.
Yeah.
Thank you. Absolutely. So we'll bring on our other captain, who is a goaltender, and he hails from Massapequa, and that would be one Michael Gennady. And we got Gennady up on the screen here. Michael, how's it going here this evening?
Pretty good. You know, I'm excited. Sam got me some good picks, so, you know, I'm ready.
Nice, nice. I like it. Feeling good about Sam's picks. Yep. Nice. So we're going to have you guys pick the defense as well as the goalies for the All Long Island game. So what we'll do is we'll start off with the defense, and you guys are first going to pick your starters. And then once the starters are selected, your starting defensemen, then we'll have you pick the reserve defensemen, and then we'll transition over to the goalies. So what we'll do is we'll flip a coin to decide who either picks first or who gets consecutive picks back to back. So what we'll do is we'll have Michael, you can call the coin toss since we brought you in second here. So you picking heads or tails? What's it going to be?
Let's go with heads.
All right. So we'll have my phone here flip a coin. Hey, Siri,
flip a coin.
It's heads this time.
It is heads. All right. So Michael, you can decide whether you want to defer and have Justice pick first and you go back-to-back picks, or would you like to select first overall?
I'm going to select first overall.
All right. So you're going to pick first of the defensemen. So in total, you'll get three picks. So you're going to make your first selection right now. So who are you going to go with as your first starting defenseman?
All right, with the first pick, let's go with Evan Ostriger.
Oh, Evan Ostriger. Okay, out of Syosset. Nice. So that's someone that I'm sure you have familiarity with being in the same conference in high school lacrosse in Nassau Class A. Yep. Someone that I'm sure your team has played against multiple times throughout the high school season. Of course, yep. Most recently in the county semifinal. But what was kind of your thought process behind going with Evan as your first overall pick?
I think he's a versatile player. You know, he can move the ball up the field. You know, he could turn the ball over. And, like, even if we need one, we could get a goal with him. So I think it's a really good first pick.
Yeah, that's a valid point. That's someone that he could potentially find the back of the net as well. So definitely watch out for that. So Ostriger, first off the board. Selected by Michael Gennady. So now, Justice, we're going to turn to you, and you'll make consecutive picks. And since you're a defenseman as well, your two picks will round out your starting lineup. So we'll have you make your first pick. We'll have their card up on the screen, talk a little bit about them, and then you'll go ahead and then proceed to make your next pick after that. So who are you going with first to make up part of your starting defense?
I'm going to go with Ben Ehlers.
Ben Ehlers. Okay, the Ward Melville Patriot. So yeah. Ben Ehlers going to Team Durham on the defensive side of the ball. Now, Justice, is this someone that you know at all, like on the club circuit, someone that you have familiarity with? Like, what was kind of your thought process in going with Ben with your first pick?
Yeah, we actually play together on Express. So, and like,
nice.
Nice.
We got the Express boys. I like it. Repping one of your guys first overall. So I like the pick. So now what we'll do is we're going to go now and you'll make your next pick as your defense. And then we'll actually then transition to LSM as well. So we'll have Justice, you can make your next pick. And then we'll go back to Gennady as an LSM starter. So Justice, we'll go back to you now for your next defensive pick.
I'm going to go with Callahan Zusai.
All right. So Callahan Zusai. Out of Islip, so we got Zusai going to Team Durham, another starter. Now, Justice, is this someone as well that you kind of know? Do you have any familiarity with?
Yeah, we actually played together at St. Anthony's before he transferred. And okay. Seen him around, yeah.
Nice, nice. So a former teammate on the high school level, now kind of reuniting in the All Long Island games. I like it. So now, Michael, we're gonna go back to you now to have you select a starting LSM. So we got plenty to choose from. Again, we got guys listed as defense and LSM. A lot of guys are kind of like hybrids. So you can really select any of the guys at your choosing as one of your starting LSM.
Yeah. All right, let's go with Donovan Rail.
Donovan Rail out of Smithtown West. So we got Rail off the board now as an LSM going to Team Michael Giannotti. So, Michael, is this someone that you know well, or what was kind of your thinking there with going with Donovan?
I'm actually not familiar with him, but from what I saw online on YouTube, like, he's a pretty good defenseman. He could turn the ball over. He's quick and good stick skills, which, you know, is always good. So that's really my thought process behind that.
Nice. You know, like, it's just so interesting, like, seeing clips of guys, like, whether it's on YouTube or Instagram, like, that can really just be a good indicator as to what they are as a player, even if it's someone that you don't know well. It's like, yeah, you never know. You may scroll across your timeline and see a clip of a guy or look them up on YouTube, and definitely gives you some good insight and could lead to you potentially playing with them. So I like this selection. So now, Justice, we'll go back to you now for your LSM, and then we'll transition, and the rest of the guys that you have to choose from will be reserves. So, Justice, who's going to be your guy at LSM?
I'm going to go with Luke Perfetti.
All right, so Luke Perfetti. Okay, so out of Wontaw. So we got the Wontaw Warrior, Luke Perfetti, off the board. Perfetti, he was definitely instrumental in Wontaw having a really good season, going all the way to the Long Island Championship game. And definitely look out for him in his senior year. So we got Perfetti now off the board. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to turn back to you, Michael, and we're going to have you make another selection here for your defense. So we're still sticking with the starters. So, Michael, you're getting another pick here. So who are you going to be rocking with next?
All right, let's go with Devin Larson.
Devin Larson, okay, the Ward Melville Patriot. So we got the Patriot Devin Larson now off the board in the 2025 class. So Larson, one of those guys for Ward Melville, a team that usually always has a really good defense, a team that is a perennial contender in Suffolk Class A. So we got Devin Larson now off the board. Now, Giannotti, you get one more poll to make up your team. So you get one more selection here. So who are you going with to wrap up your starters?
I'm going to go with Matt Golia.
All right. So Matt Golia out of Cold Spring Harbor, a 2025 now, going to Team Giannotti. So, Michael, any thoughts or any ideas? What was the thought process there with going with Golia? Someone you know?
Yeah, well, I'm familiar with him from Regulators playing club together. So I know he's a solid base defenseman. Despite the injuries, you know, I bet it'll be great on the field out there. So that's my thought process.
Nice, nice. Going with one of your guys. Never a bad idea. So we got, looks like we have our starters now selected for the defense. Now we're going to transition to the goalies. And so what we'll do is we'll have Michael, you get first selection. So we'll have you pick first of the goaltenders that you have to choose from to be your teammates. So, Michael, who are you going to be selecting first overall?
I'm going to go with Andrew McKenzie.
Okay, so we got Andrew McKenzie off the board, someone that I figure you know very well. But, Michael, you just want to kind of talk about going with Andrew as your first overall selection?
Yeah, so, like, I feel like it's, like, 100% my first pick there, going with Andrew. Big goaltender. Makes big saves, you know. It's hard to get by him. Moves to the ball well. So, so familiar to me. So, it should be nice to play with him.
Nice. I like the familiarity aspect and picking your guy. So, yeah. So you got McKenzie off the board. So, now, Justice, you get back-to-back picks of the goalies that we have remaining. So, you'll make your first pick, and we'll once again display their card. So, Justice, who you going with?
I'm going to go with Dylan Rappaport.
Dylan Rappaport, another St. Anthony's Friar. So, Justice, was that kind of your thinking there, going with a fellow St. Anthony's Friar?
Yeah.
Nice. So we got Rappaport, the 26. Definitely watch out for him over the next couple years, playing for one of the most storied programs in the nation. So we got Rappaport going to Team Durham. So, Justice, you get another selection at goalie. So who will be your next goaltender?
Scotty Nelson.
Scotty Nelson, one of the 25s out of MacArthur. And so Scotty Nelson, again, for the college coaches out there, definitely got to give a look at Scotty Nelson as one of those uncommitted 25s. Having a chance to cover him at multiple events. So really, really glad that we got Scotty involved here. And so he'll be going to Team Durham. So that means we got two more goalies to choose from. So now, Michael, it goes back to you. So who's going to be your next goaltender?
I'm going to go with Patrick Ganley.
Patrick Ganley out of Sachem North. So Ganley going to Team Gennady in the 2026 class. So we got Ganley now off the board, coming from one of those Suffolk Class A teams out at Sachem. Had a chance to cover that rivalry this past season, Sachem East and Sachem North. So we got Ganley off the board now, which means we have one goalie left. So Justice, if you don't mind, just reading our final goaltender's name, please.
We're going to take Gavin Mantle.
So Gavin Mantle out of ESM. Mantle, another 2026 goalie. And he was ESM starting goalie this past season. So Gavin getting a chance to take the cage for the ESM Sharks as a sophomore. So definitely the arrow can only trend upward for Gavin as he'll be entering his junior season next year. But Gavin Mantle, our last goalie, taken off the board here. So we have everyone selected for the defense and the goalies. So I just want to thank you guys for being part of this. Okay, so as we continue with the All Long Island Draft, now we're going to be presenting the rosters for the younger age groups. So that would be the classes of 2027 down to the classes of 2030. So we'll be presenting both the black and the silver team for those age groups. And we're going to start with the class of 2027, the rising sophomores, who many of which they'll be shooting to make varsity for the first time coming up next spring at their respective high schools. Coming up next, we're presenting the class of 2028, as these young guns are taking that jump from middle school to high school, where they'll be looking to take that next step, suiting up for their high school programs for the first time for many of them, as they'll be taking their game to that JV level for their respective high schools. Now we present the class of 2029, as these rising eighth graders are ready to burst onto the scene starting this summer with their last summer of middle school ball as they get set to enter their final chapter of junior high school. And last but certainly not least, we have our youngest age group, the class of 2030, as these rising seventh graders are going to be making a ton of noise this summer, leading into what will be their first year of middle school lacrosse next spring for their respective junior high schools. So we got everyone back here. So guys, first and foremost, just want to thank you again for accepting the honor of being a captain and taking part in the virtual draft for the All Long Island Games. And we're looking forward to seeing you guys in the game on June 19th and beyond June and the All Long Island Games, just continuing to cover you guys throughout your high school careers with still a couple years left here. So just want to thank you guys first and foremost. Followed by, I'd just like to thank our sponsors, Gate Lacrosse, East Fitness LI, Heatherwood Communities, and I'd like to thank East Fitness LI, our production team, our production partner, for putting together this draft. So definitely just want to thank everyone that was able to make this happen and put it all together. But thanks again, guys, for being a part of this. I hope you really enjoyed it.
Thanks so much for having me.
Thanks for the opportunity.